you're looking for your brother, please come in. If I'm the one you want, I'm on my way to see my husband.
Mr. Woodard had a coronary.
I'm very sorry. Thank you. I'm going to be on my way now. A bad one?
Very bad.
He was getting along so well. It's sad. I was looking for you because I have an insurance company report on the Pageant's case disease that you were working on during the strike. It's only a formality, but I need you to sign it. 5 copies.
Sure. Were you outside the door very long?
Long enough.
What does that mean?
That means that I understand that you and Mrs. Woodard were, how do you say it? More than friends?
Jill, for Ray's sake, as well as my own, I'm going to ask you to forget whatever it was you heard.
Certainly, Roger. I mean, it doesn't give me any pleasure contemplating you and your patient's wife having a love affair.
Jill, you're making it sound like it was a sordid affair, and it wasn't. But I don't think that you understand Ray. She's a nice, bright, independent woman who is quite alone.
I think she's very capable of taking care of herself.
And a lady of whom I am very fond.
Roger, I don't want to get into a discussion about Mrs. Woodard's character. I mean, it doesn't seem very productive to me.
No, because a discussion requires an open mind, and I'm not so sure that you have one where she's concerned.
I think you're probably right. I'm not sure that I do.
You never liked my taste in women. The fact is that I like ladies who know what they want and go after it.
What exactly does she want?
Right now, she wants her husband to live. And I'm very much afraid that that isn't going to happen.
Phil? Can you hear me? It's Ray.
Saloon keeper today.
Must be 18 or older to order. You can call 1-800-503-1740.
Hi, baby.
Hi.
Hello.
How's my favorite saloon keeper today?
Well, I'm feeling pretty good now.
Because Mary's coming home?
No, because Mary's coming home and because you just walked through the door.
Oh, thank you. You know, Johnny, of all the people in this entire world, you're the person that I've known the longest. Not counting Roger and Jill.
Yeah, I guess our friendship began, you were about 6 weeks old. Your father came in here and set you right down on the bar.
And my mother had a fit when she heard about it. Or so they told me.
Oh, she did indeed. Very proper lady, your mother. Very proper.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm glad she didn't spoil our friendship.
I am too.
Have you seen Pat today?
No, I haven't.
Bucky and I've been a little worried about him.
Well, I guess we've all been worried about him, you know. But I think everything's gonna be all right now, don't you? I mean, the letters of reprimand are out of his file. Delia's out of the hospital. And things are gonna get better, right?
I hope so. So, is today really the day that Jack and Mary are getting back?
Today's the day.
What time?
I don't know for sure. I'll tell you one thing, though. From Mary's letters, Jack's been a better sport to her than I ever would have thought possible. She's having the time of her life. But I think by now she'd be anxious to get home.
Oh, I don't want to leave. I want to do it all over again. Little inns,
Morans and those incredible oysters. Climbing Knotton Array, Yates Tower, Lissadell. Jack, do we really have to go?
If we stay, we'll have to send for Ryan.
Oh, I wish we could.
Next year.
All right. Oh, you're so smart. Thank you for bringing me here. It's been the best honeymoon ever. It's funny, but going through a town makes me want to go home all of a sudden.
A girl out of the city.
And am I glad you did.
They'll never let us get on a plane with all this stuff.
Well, maybe we should just dump everything and run for it.
Yeah, well, you just did.
I want to buy everything.
What's duty-free mean?
For a newspaper man, you're not very smart, Fenelli. It means we can take it home without paying duty. I think I will buy everything.
He's got things for me. Maybe I ought to pick up something for my old da-in-law. How much could he hate a necktie, anyway? Green necktie with shamrocks all over it. Ah, too corny. I don't know. The other hand, he might just love it. What the hell?
I don't care if we already did buy Christmas presents. Everyone can have two presents. Besides, Doc can't get this at home.
Hey, not much time left.
You've never seen me really shop. Just watch my dust.
May I stay with you for a while? I want so much to talk to you. Can he hear me?
We think so, but we're never sure.
Does he know what's happening to him?
Oh, yes, he knows he's a very sick man.
Is there any chance?
Well, his heart took a lot of punishment, a lot of damage. I'd like to give you some hope, but I can't.
Not even an outside chance?
Not even that.
You've tried everything? Surgery, specialists?
Mrs. Woodard, even if we could try something, there just wouldn't be enough time.
He's dying right now.
Yes.
How long?
5 minutes, a few hours at best.
Thank you for telling me. I'm going to believe that you can hear me. Because there are some things I want to tell you. Hey, you with me, huh? Hello? What I'm going to tell you is the absolute truth. Will you try to believe that?
I'll listen.
I want you to know how sorry I am about what happened. It was such a sad, silly thing to do. And it didn't mean a thing. I love you. You're the only man I ever loved.
Yes.
The worst of it all is, I never ever wanted to hurt you. Never. The very first time I met you, back in that corridor in Kansas City, I knew you were very special for me. And over the years, every time you'd stop whatever it was you were doing, teach me about the business, or people, I knew you were an amazing man. You know, I was in love with you long before you ever even noticed me. Believe it?
Yes.
I still am. We're good together. We're such a good team. That's why I'm hoping we can go on now. Together. So I can make up to you for what I've done.
No need.
Oh, yes, there's a need. Such a need. I need us to have our dreams together. You to be a senator yourself.
Like that.
Otherwise, how am I ever going to get to Washington? Be your hostess. You and me, against the whole world.
Well, I just like that.
Yeah. Still is. Still is. Because you are the nicest and the smartest. Best in the business.
You always said that.
I'm trying. I'm trying so hard to tell you how much I love you. What? Bill, I didn't hear you. What did you say?
I'm sorry.
He's dead.
Yes, but he didn't suffer. It was quick.
Thank you. It shouldn't have happened.
The heart attack?
I did it.
Mrs. Wood, the condition your husband's heart was in, a coronary, was inevitable sooner or later.
I made it sooner. Thank you.
I don't want to get off the plane. Because then, it's really over.
Anxious to have them back than they are to come home.
I can't wait to hear all about it.
Listen, you're off duty, aren't you? How about a little drink?
Okay. Will you make it really light? I promised to cook dinner for Tom, and I think I should have my wits about me.
All right. How about a light scotch and water?
Terrific. Johnny?
Yeah?
When you were a fighter, what class did you box in?
Well, light heavyweight, up to a 175 limit.
You could make 175?
Well, I could in those days. I'd probably have a little trouble making the limit now, but with a little practice, I could...
I just meant that you're so muscular, I didn't think you could get down that low.
Oh. Well, I mean, a couple of days before the weigh-in, you know, I start... Good. Ryan's!
Oh, would that be himself I'm talking to? Is that you, John Ryan?
Jack, is that you?
I'm reporting that I brought your daughter back safe over the Atlantic Ocean. We're home.
Ah, that's great. Welcome back, Jack.
Thank you, Johnny. Trip was fantastic. Look, we'll be along as soon as we can.
How's Mary?
Better than ever, except she brought back half Ireland, so customs may take us a little time.
Well, listen, whenever you get here, we'll be waiting for you.
We're looking forward to it. Can't wait to get our hands on Ryan. Our love to Maeve, huh?
Right, right. We'll see you soon, Jack. There's one thing I can't stand, though, and it unnerves me, is Jack Fenelli being sweet as sugar.
Why don't you just try enjoying it? After all, it may not last that long.
You're right. I can't wait for Maeve to get back from Mass. Mary's coming back!
Is any change in Bill Laird's condition?
It's a matter of time.
Yeah. Excuse me. Hey, Ray.
He died a few minutes ago.
Well, I'm so sorry.
Thank you.
Mrs. Woodard, may I offer my sincerest condolences?
Thank you.
Were you there?
Yeah. I held him. He talked for a while, and then...
Well, at least you were with him.
Yes.
And you gave him all the help that you could.
He deserved better.
That's not fair, Ray. If I can go by what I've seen, you've been a very loving and devoted wife. You stood by him, you fought for him. You don't have anything to reproach yourself for.
I disappointed him.
No, you didn't. Please, listen. During the last 3 weeks, I spent a lot of time with Bill, and two things he loved to talk about the most were politics and you were by far his favorite subject.
That's nice.
And I never heard him say anything to even suggest that he was disappointed in you.
Never?
Never. There's one time when he was disappointed with someone who he was working with who was lying to him, but he didn't let you in on it because he knew that you were fond of that person, too. So he asked for my advice without consulting you, but it's the only time.
What did you suggest?
I told him to find the truth before he did anything.
Sound advice.
Yeah, if I'm babbling, all I want you to understand is that he loved you. And...
Thank you. Thank you. Please, I know what you're trying to do.
Yeah, I'm trying to help. Ray, what about right now? There's bound to be a huge reaction in the press, political friends, family.
Oh, no, please, just give me a minute to...
Oh, certainly.
Roger? What's going on?
Bill Woodard just died.
Oh, I'm really sorry for her. I know Frank was getting very close to him, too.
Look, would you like to go someplace by yourself and just cry?
No, please. Talk to me, would you?
Look, I need your signature. You forgot to sign this one.
How about the hospital PR guy, Tom Desmond, handling the press people? He did a very good job of it when Bill was first admitted to the hospital.
That's a very good idea. Thank you very much.
And do you know of anyone you can get a hold of to help with the arrangements, family, and that sort of thing?
Yes, of course. My friend, Polly Longworth, she could help. Maybe she could get one or two of the girls from the office.
Yeah, I think it'd be a good idea.
I'll go call her right now. Funny. I know her number as well as I know my own, and I can't remember it.
Look, why don't I call her for you?
Please, her number is in a little book that is in my purse that's in... I am not going to do this.
There's no law that says you can't go and cry.
The worst of it is... after everything... he tried to kiss me goodbye.